Boogie Woogie is just plain fun.
Well, I'm amazed at how physical it is.
And it is very physical.
When I watch you in concert, you're throwing your whole body into it. And I remember seeing Hatta even at the age... How old was she when she...
She was almost 90.
Oh, my gosh.
She was almost made 90.
Yeah.
And she played up till... The shows we did with her were about 3 months before she left us.
Wow.
And she was rocket.
Yeah.
Well, Hatta was a very interesting artist. And like many of the Boogie Woogie artists, they actually played a lot more than Boogie Woogie. They're very broad. Albert Ammons and Pete Johnson played a lot of music. Hazel Scott played a lot of music. Mary Lou Williams played amazing jazz artist as well. Mm-hmm. So Hatta, in keeping with that, she was also the first black woman to have her own television show.
I didn't know that.
Yeah, mm-hmm. Yeah. She did a lot of torch songs. She was a very important woman in the history of American film and music. And it's great that you're doing this series so that more knowledge about a lot of these artists who didn't really get their due is shared with new generations of players.
Yeah.
Her work is there to inspire many. So she got started when she was about 17. As I said earlier, she was recorded in the front of a furniture store. In the 40s, records were recorded at furniture stores. That's where they were sold, because that's where the Victrolas were sold. So seems funny now. And a lot of these stores would have little studios set up in the front part. And it was not that hard to start up a label back then. There were a lot of smaller labels. And especially in Los Angeles and South Central, there was so much talent going on. There were many, many small labels. And so Hatta got started with that. And up until in her 80s, she actually did release a new double album. She is available on Amazon. And I would recommend checking out her last release.
Well, it's been so great to have Wendy on, because not only to talk about the women Boogie Woogie pianists and songwriters, but also because we've been able to focus on this West Coast aspect of jazz and blues. So much of that jazz history, really, we talk about Chicago a lot, we talk about New York, we certainly talk about New Orleans, but the West Coast focus is such a really intriguing chapter in this story. So I'm so glad that Wendy's brought that to our attention. And I know that, Wendy, you've got some suggested, we always like to close the show with a few suggested listening and a way to further this, this research on your own. What do you recommend for us?
Well, there's a few books that I would check out. They're not explicitly on women in Boogie Woogie, but they do cover some of the women, and they give a feel for the whole scene and what it was like. California Soul deals with the gospel music arriving on the West Coast, jazz, with the whole South Central scene taking off, and how important the Bay Area was in that scene as well.
Mm.
And Oakland and San Francisco and Richmond played a big role in that, and that's nice to see now with what's happening culturally around Oakland and Richmond. At one time, it was very prosperous and very rich, and we have that as a strong Bay Area heritage. One of my other favorite books, specifically more with blues, but blues and boogie woogie cross paths a lot, is Looking Up at Down. Moving on to some listening, I would say that, of course, Hatta Brooks material, which is still in print, Hazel Scott still in print, Mary Lou Williams still in print.
But Wendy, where can people find out about your concerts and your compositions and your what's going on with you?
I'm at wendydewitt.com. And there's links for all kinds of information on my website, how to buy my CDs, my calendar, where we're going to be touring, and a show that we put on every year that kind of ties to what you're doing with the Wild Women of Song is we've been doing the Queens of Boogie Woogie for going on our 13th year.
So for you Bay Area fans that are watching, those Queens of Boogie Woogie nights at Yoshi's, which Wendy has produced, was such a great and sisterly thing to do to promote these fellow women that are after this very strong and beautiful viewpoint on music. And each of you had such a completely different take about what this sound was. I was completely fascinated.
It's broad.
So I want to urge all of you to check out Wendy's website, and then also to please continue to urge your friends to subscribe to the Wild Women of Song channel on YouTube. Every week we try to bring you something a little new and a little different. Thanks for tuning in.
Great work, Pamela.
I used to lie awake and wonder if there could ever be